Hey everyone, welcome back to Skyrim Special Edition. We've just entered Leafall's Barrow, and I'm gonna read my two spell tunes because I really want to use those spells, and also this letter. Hawk, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Sithgir, and I have the honor to be the Jarl of the proud and ancient city of Falkreath. The fame of your exploits across Skyrim has brought you to my attention. If you are interested in becoming the Thane of Falkreath Hold, I invite you to speak to me the next time you're in Falkreath. Aside from the honor that accrues to the title, my Thanes are entitled to personal housecarl. I also can tell you privately that a choice parcel of land in Falkreath would be available for your purchase should your services prove useful to me. I look forward to meeting you in person. I remain Jarl Sithgir of Falkreath. So yeah, that's the Heartfire quest, or content really, that you can start from there. I mean, Falkreath probably does have the best land available to all players, but I personally still like Morthal's Heartfire content. I'm gonna have to go through all of the houses anyway, so it doesn't really matter where I start. Although, incidentally, in Requiem, you'll definitely hang around Whiterun and Falkreath in the beginning of the game, so if you want to start a Heartfire content really early, you'll definitely start with Falkreath. Anyway, I got an Amulet of Mara. That's mostly used for starting up a wedding with an NPC of your choice. Well, not exactly of your choice, but NPC that can be married. Right here, in Requiem, there will be a silver katana. However, because this is regular unmodded Skyrim, I wouldn't need such a weapon, so there is none. That bandit caught me, but usually if a bandit has a bow, it means that their weapon of choice in melee will be a dagger. And bandits with daggers are really, really weak. Anyway, as I was saying, but where I was at, I said there was a silver katana. That katana is there because silver weapons are extremely effective against the undead in Requiem, and the undead in general are super powerful in that mod, so you'll definitely want that silver katana if you're like not really prepared for taking on Bleakfall's Barrow. Even though it's an early dungeon, like dragons are extremely tough in Requiem, so the whole dungeon was buffed so that unless you know what you're doing, you won't survive it. But I can tell you all from experience that it is possible to beat Bleakfall's Barrow in level 1 in Requiem. If you like use that silver katana, make good usage of the scrolls of fireball, and just plain take your time and take out all of the enemies through traps and stuff. Although personally I also use Revenge of the Enemies, so it'll be quite difficult to take the boss on in Requiem with that other mod. Because Revenge of the Enemies Jogger have really powerful abilities and unique spells that are hard to counter. Normally that bandit over there is gonna kill himself, but I actually want to practice on him. However, it's a bandit thug, so there's no way I can kill him in a timely manner. So after those two arrows, I just leave him alone and decide to watch him get himself killed. So yeah, he's walking towards that lever over there. I don't know if you can all see it. This video is 1080p. He activates the lever. That activates a trap. And even though he's got a ton of health for a bandit thug, it's always gonna kill him instantly. Like, it's scripted that way. If you fall for the trap yourself, I don't believe it'll cause that much damage because this is a unmodded Skyrim, but in Requiem, traps hurt a lot. Anyway, in case any of you are paying attention, it's Snake Snake Whale, the puzzle solution. And once you figure out the solution to this puzzle, you figure out the solution to every other spinning rock puzzle in Skyrim. They're really not that complex. Here I got a level up and I decide to use it on archery. Yeah, I want Eagle Eye. Critical shot's okay, I guess. But Eagle Eye is neat because it adds a new option for like how you use your bow. And that's fun. Adding new gameplay elements through perks is very, very fun. Also, there's some skeevers right around here. Those will be annoying. Right here. Skeevers are not strong, but they can give you some diseases. And I really don't want to get a disease right now. Although, incidentally, in the next video, I will be getting a pretty popular disease. Popular because some people actually want a disease occasionally. Anyway, yeah, Scroll of Fireball right here. Not extremely useful in unmodded Skyrim, but very much so in Requiem because you face off against a lot of Draugr. That's Arvel the Swift. He's in trouble right now, but we don't really care about him. What we want is this treasure chest right over here. It's well hidden. The reward for finding it is not that great, unfortunately. One of the consequences of unmodded Skyrim is that all of the... Well, most of the chest rewards are random. Or leveled, rather. Anyway, mini-boss. A giant spider. The wounded frostbite spider. It's probably not that strong, but... I do believe that giant spiders in unmodded Skyrim actually can give you trouble if you're not careful. When you find them out in the open, anyway, because right, this spider right here, doesn't matter how tough it is, it can never leave its small arena. So besides that spin attack it used on me right there, it can't really damage me. Like even if I run out of arrows, I've got my fireball spark spell that I can use on it from a distance. And since it will never like be able to get outside of its little arena, I'm safe forever, and I will eventually defeat it, no matter what. Well, in any case, it takes a couple of arrows to completely defeat it, but it's really not that tough. That actually reminds me that my regular modded Skyrim game has some really weak spiders, even though they're supposed to be strong. I think it's because my load order is a bit flawed. Like Revenge of the Enemies doesn't have a proper patch for Requiem, maybe? It's weird because I remember a while ago before that I actually like had the right load order for making the my Requiem spider still strong and still have the perks of being coupled with the Revenge of the Enemies buffs. But for some reason it doesn't work. Anyway, I'm gonna finish this spider in style. Boom! I kind of wish it would explode into tiny bits, but no, this is not Resident Evil 4. There is decapitation in this game, but it's only through kill moves, unfortunately. I guess there might be some mods that also allow you to decapitate the enemies even without kill moves, however.
Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door, and the hall of stories. I know how they all fit together. Help me down and I'll show you. You won't believe the power the Nords have hidden there. Sweet breath of Arcade, thank you.
So, Arvel wants us to cut him down. He means that literally. He wants us to kill him. Well, no, he doesn't really want to. But it's the game sort of kind of telling you, hey, you should probably kill this guy because he's a jerk. And he is, but I decided to be not a jerk and give him a head start. Because he's gonna die no matter what. Mostly because he's dumb. He's gonna try to fight the Draugr that awaken right here. Anyway, what I'm doing right here, using arrows on a Draugr, that would not deal any damage against that enemy in Requiem. Unless it was a silver arrow. But even then, silver arrows are not that effective. I actually wanted to finish Arvel myself, but unfortunately, I could not hit him for some reason. Using spells on that enemy was a bad idea because it detected me, but the other ones did not. They did not. I do believe there is a perk called Silent Spells that can be acquired in unmodded Skyrim, so if you want to not get caught while casting spells, you'll have your opportunity. Maybe? To be honest, now that I think about it, maybe I'm thinking of Skyri, or Perma, as it is called now. I think. Maybe. Whatever the case. I got the Golden Claw and Arvel's Journal. So we're going to read Arvel's Journal right here. My fingers are trembling. The Golden Claw is finally in my hands, and wielded the power of the ancient Nordic heroes. That fool Lucan Valerius had no idea that his favorite store decoration was actually the key to Bleakfall's Barrow. Now I just need to get to the Hall of Stories and lock that door. The legend says there is a test that the Nords put in place to keep the unworthy away, but that when you have the Golden Claw, the solution is in the palm of your hands. I never really properly read Arvel's Journal back when I first played Skyrim, so I didn't get the hint about the solution being in the palm of your hands. It also doesn't help that I was not aware of how the menu worked. But anyway, yeah, you go on the Golden Claw, and then you can, if you hold the left click button, you can make the claw move like this, and then you can see that it's got symbols on it, and that's how you solve all of the Hall of Story solutions, basically all of the gates involving the claws. And that's really boring. It really, really is, because I thought the solution would be found through a different manner. I at least would have appreciated a different way of solving the Hall of Stories, is basically what I'm saying. Restless Draugr have way too much health for my character right now. I used the trap on this enemy, and it did work, but it did not kill it instantly. In Requiem, it definitely would have, because traps deal like 10 times normal damage. And enemies have less health in general. I try to keep my distance from this enemy because it used spells on me, but it often used, like, Draugr in general, often use melee. There is one specific Draugr you want to be especially careful of, however, the Death Lords. They usually come with bows with ebony arrows, and that usually means they will kill you instantly, or get very close to it at the very least. More Draugr right here. Don't know how I missed that shot right there. I guess I was still not used to the way arrows arc in unmodded Skyrim. And of course, they're all restless Draugr, so I decided to use the trap again. I used it well this time. I'm waiting for the other Draugr to come over, but they're not being very cooperative right now. Probably because they didn't detect me. If you listen to the music, you can actually usually tell when an opponent is like too tough for you. As far as the game is concerned, anyway. So I didn't actually manage to hit that Restless Draugr with the trap, but I did leave it behind the gate, at least for a moment. That's kind of bad, to be honest, because it means the gate might be completely disabled, so I would never be able to use it ever again. Fortunately, I can use it again. However, unfortunately, it did not get caught by the trap, so I have to fight it the old-fashioned way. The Draugr, not the gate. Although, interestingly enough, the thing about those gates is that you can actually block their hits if you have a shield. At least I think you can. I may be wrong. I might test it at some point, because they don't deal that much damage in this in unmodded Skyrim. In Requiem, though, they definitely will kill you instantly, or get very close to it. That's just a normal Draugr. So it's obviously it stands no chance against my arrows. This isn't too tough, and it doesn't... Well, it doesn't deal that much damage. I mean, four hits and I'm dead, but it really doesn't deal that much damage. Seriously. I don't recommend trying to practice light armor through this trap, however. I don't think it works, to be honest. However, if you get damaged, you will always be training restoration when using your healing spells. So, if you want to train restoration, be my guest. Just a normal Draugr. Oh, and here we have a pretty obvious setup to use those lamps to cause a fire through fuel, but it's not that effective, unfortunately. In Requiem it is, however, because traps deal more damage, but even then it's still not that effective, unfortunately. So yeah, I don't think I'll ever recommend doing that trap. It's mostly to protect yourself, honestly. Here I actually purposely activated those things again because it works on the enemies too, because, you know, that's the logical thing. However, these enemies, or at least one of these enemies, actually survived the trap and almost killed me. Right here, I should have kept running. Unfortunately, I got overconfident about this trap right here. Like, seriously. It failed before. Why would it not fail again? So, right here, I paused the game because I was concerned about finally dying, and... So, I got lucky, fortunately. Like, it has been a while since I've died, right? I won't edit out any of my deaths. I do believe it happens in later videos because of how tough the enemies get, but... right now, I'm still safe. I really, really am. And I was such a huge coward that I decided to accelerate this section of the video right here because it takes so long for me to get back to where I wanted to be. And I wanted revenge on that restless Draugr, but I mean, look at what happens right here. Dumb zombie. Here's another interesting thing about Draugr in Requiem. They don't actually normally carry good stuff. Like, that one back there had money and a petty soul gem. I don't believe they ever carry that kind of stuff in Requiem. Usually it's only their weapon and a shield and... Yeah, I think that would be it. Maybe gold anyway, but... Not likely, and not that much. One more Draugr right over here. It's all alone and it won't like detect me until it's too late, so easy peasy. Oh, also I started training my alteration magic here If you cast an alteration spell before entering combat, it won't do anything for your skill. However, as soon as you enter combat, assuming the effect is still on you, it will train your alteration skill. So casting an alteration spell before entering combat is not a bad idea. And as I implied before, if you really want to, you can just buy a bunch of Magicka potions, get into combat with a mud crab, and just repeatedly cast whatever alteration spell you've got over and over and over and over, and you'll quickly get to 100. I'm serious. That's how you can do it. Considering, you can level up with your magic over time until you're level 80, and when you've got 100 in alteration skill, you can turn the spell legendary so it resets at 15, and just do the same process again, except since you have so much Magicka now, it'll be even easier. So yeah, alteration is one of those skill trees that probably really help for a player who wants to get to even higher levels. However, if you're going to get into modded Skyrim, just use the Uncapper. It allows your skills to level up even beyond level 100. Up to 999. So you don't have to feel forced to learn the two-handed skill tree to gain more experience or something. Because I'm never going to really reset my archery skill tree, or my sneak skill tree. Well, maybe sneak, but only once. Wait, actually, now that I think about it, when you make a skill tree legendary, do you lose all the perks? I think you should. Right? Because in the Dragonborn DLC, there's this reward at the end where you can get all of the perks of a certain skill tree through sacrificing a dragon soul or something, and that's how you get the perks from that skill tree, right? But if you I don't know what I'm saying right now. I'm sorry. I'm just confused. It's been such a long time since I played Unmodded Skyrim. We're just going to find out ourselves when I need to cross that bridge or something. Because I think there's an achievement tied to making a skill legendary. Right here, where I am, that Draugr cannot even see me. That's pathetic. Seriously, what an embarrassment. I know it's a zombie, but come on. It's gotta have more brains than this. Yeah, check in random skeletons for gold. That's not something you ever do in Requiem. If you check a skeleton, you're likely to only find a skull. I'm sorry if I'm sneaking too much, but it's just how I'm used to exploring Bleak Falls Barrow, or just dungeons in general. The only time I would not be continuously sneaking is if I was doing a heavy armor character. And, well, I'm not doing that right now, am I? Because, you know, heavy armor is extremely useless in Unmodded Skyrim. Very, very powerful in Requiem, however. Also, right here, I didn't think that, actually, no, I assumed that the Draugr found me because I casted that spell, but it's actually because they saw me. At least that's what I believe. In whatever case, I run away like a bitch, and Yeah, having taken the easy route to defeating that restless Draugr. Because they have so much health. Long enough, jeez. Yeah, it's not even the toughest type of Draugr. There's still the Draugr White, and not white as in W-H-I-T-E, white as in W-H-I-G-T, I think, right? Or is it W-I-G-H-T? Whatever the case, it's the next level to a Draugr, and it takes even more arrows for me to defeat them, so I'm not ready for those even after the end of the session. And then there's the Draugr Deathlord, which has even more HP, and is just pretty much straight up impossible at my level. Don't know why I'm taking so much time trying to pick this lock. It's just an apprentice lock, nothing special. And yeah, you're gonna be seeing this in some dungeons, part where you will like reach a new section. The bigger dungeons have three, most of them have two, and some of the minor ones only have one. But usually you'll always find at least one segment where you'll have to like enter a new cell. And that's good too, y'all know that? That's good. There are some mods that love to have the player enter humongous areas with like no loading cells anywhere, and it's great to look at, but it tends to crash very often, you know? It tends to crash very, very often. I deactivated a trap right there, but I think it was fine in the end because it's all Draugrs. Yeah, they're all Draugrs, so it's fine in the end, but normally I would use the trap to get rid of these enemies. Oh, incidentally, that trap reactivates when I backtrack to here. Kind of, it's basically proof that Bethesda put a trap activator somewhere around here that is unavoidable. Like, there's literally no way you can avoid activating the trap. This thing right here, or these things right here. Incidentally, that other zombie right here was still alive back when I was taking care of the other one, but as soon as I activated that trap, it died because it was in the middle of it. That's kind of funny. It's the kind of stuff that really makes me like this game and the Elder Scrolls in general. The freedom for anything to happen. No, if only it wouldn't crash so often, particularly when I have mods on. I mean, I started this playthrough because my modded Skyrim game like wouldn't work properly. It really is just because of my load order, though. I probably should like double check it or remove some more mods. I mean, I don't know. There's some texture mods I could get rid of. But there are definitely some mods I will never, ever part with. Requiem for one. Dragon Combat Overhaul is another one. Frostfall. And Campfire by extension now. And, well, whatever. Now, this is the Hall of Stories. This is the gate with the reins. I originally thought that the solution to that puzzle right over there was by looking at these murals. Studying them. Looking at what the characters were doing to figure out which animal is supposed to go where. Turns out I was wrong. Dead wrong. And apparently Bethesda... I wasn't the only one, because Bethesda put a... sort of, kind of, take that on the Dragon Ball... Dragon Ball. Yeah, Dragon Ball. Dragonborn DLC, where an NPC is like, hey, look at these murals. If we study them, maybe we'll figure out a solution to this gate. And he does, but whatever. Anyway, the solution to this one is to activate each of the reins twice. So that you have the bear, moth, and owl. If you look at the claw itself, it's going to have those markings as well, so it's easy. But yeah, those murals, I thought those had the solution. Now, it would have been better that way, because for each dungeon, you would have to study the murals or have to find a different set of murals in the dungeon itself to figure out the solution to this thing right here. But nope, as soon as you have the claw, you have the solution. And you'll always have the claw for each of these murals. Well, mostly. There are like one or two dungeons where you have to get the claw from somewhere else, but you're unlikely to go into those dungeons until you have the claw. Anyway, normally in this area, this humongous area, there would be a ton of Draugr around. At least in Requiem. In Unmodded Skyrim, there's only one Draugr, and it's in that thing right over there, near the treasure chest. This tomb. But first, let's look at this. A ward of power. Yeah, Draugr Overlord. That's not a Draugr you encounter normally. He can use shouts on us, but they're not very effective. And you see, it is his only attack that he can use from a distance, so yeah, he's not going to be trouble at all. In fact, his shout is so weak that I regenerate health while he's on his cooldown. If his shout would actually push me around through, like, kinetic force, it would be dangerous. But because it does not, it is weak. And basically harmless in general. You know, yeah, this is basically the entire boss fight, so let's skip ahead a bit. Imagine facing five Draugrs like this, huh? Wouldn't that be fun? It's the kind of stuff I would have to do if I was to do the companion's questline right away. Which is kind of what I did. Several videos from now, you'll see. But, yeah. Draugr Overlord dead. Make sure to check his stuff because he's got some important stuff. Specifically the Dragon Stone. He's also got a great sword of cold if you want to disenchant that. And don't forget the treasure chest itself. Oh, also, I've got a new option right here, shouts. However, I cannot use it just yet. But Unrelenting Force is definitely the first shout that you start unlocking. Elven boots are better than my current boots, so I take them. Not to mention they're more appropriate for my character considering they're an elf. But, I mean, I am a dark elf. Dark elves are not commonly seen in that kind of elven armor. They've got, like, since the Dragon Ball... it's Dragonborn! Not Dragon Ball. Since because of the Dragonborn DLC, they've got their own sets of clothes, the dark elves, or Dunmer. So seeing them in, like, elven armor feels like not as appropriate as it should be. Elven armor is more of a high elf thing. But yeah, that was Bleak Falls Barrow. Next time, we're going to be going back to Riverwood and then Whiterun to do our first dragon battle, maybe, if I remember things right. Whatever the case, I hope you've all enjoyed this video and I'll have a very nice day. Bye-bye!